Today, I want to spend a little time talking about something that we actually talk about quite a bit in the gun community, and that is choosing between caliber or power and capacity when choosing your EDC, the gun you're going to carry every day. Is it more important to you that a gun have more rounds, like this Beretta here? This is my Elite LTT, and it holds 19 rounds of 9mm, has an 18-round magazine, plus one in the pipe. So this gun has, like I said, 19 rounds. Is that more important to you, or are you someone who cares more about power, and therefore you go up to a bigger caliber, like the 10mm here, but you give up some capacity because this only carries 10 rounds, a 9-round magazine, and one in the pipe. Now, this video today isn't about brand or anything like that, so just disregard that this is a Beretta and that this is a Kimber. Whether you like Berettas or Kimbers, whatever, that doesn't matter. What we're talking about here today is purely the power or caliber versus the capacity of each of these guns for everyday carry, and which is more important to you. And you notice I say more important to you, not which is better. So many times in the gun community, I see so many tacti-tard guys, usually the tacti-tards, that want to say, this is the right way to do this, and that is the right way to do this, and that is the wrong way to do this. And sometimes that's applicable, but mostly it isn't in the situations where they try to pretend like there's only one way to do something. There are multiple ways to do things in the gun community and with guns, just like there's multiple reasons why you would choose which one of these guns is better for you. It's not just the size and the weights of the guns. There's a lot of other different things to consider to decide whether you would rather have more rounds or more potent rounds. Now, I know some people like to pretend that when it comes to self-defense and handguns, that all rounds are pretty much the same. Well, that's very short-sighted thinking. That's very much an oversimplification of reality. So I'm going to disregard that right off the bat because it's just not true. That's a video for another day, but it's just not true. There are things to consider that would definitely show you the difference between these two guns when it comes to their caliber and their capacity. When it comes to self-defense, we all have our own little scenarios in our head that we think are the ones we want to be most prepared for. That's a very subjective thing. We all have different ideas of what's important. Let's say one of the things you've thought about is that we live in the age of Antifa and Unite the Right rallies, so finding yourself between two warring factions of these very violent groups is something you might want to be prepared for. And in that case, you're probably going to think that 19 rounds of 9mm is way better than 10 rounds of 10mm because you get more chances to fire and you get more options of firing on more targets with this simply because you have more rounds. That little bit of extra power from the 10mm isn't important to you at that point in time. What's important to you is you have as many rounds as possible, so the 9mm would be a better choice for you. Or let's say you're someone that's like, wow, we've seen a lot of people using trucks as weapons against civilians, and in that situation, I'm going to want a weapon that can actually penetrate a windshield and still be effective against the person in the cab. In that case, the 10mm might be much more important to you. It's going to do a better job at penetrating the glass and then still being effective after it does than the 9mm. Wouldn't matter how many rounds of 9mm you have, if they're not getting the job done, the 10mm would be much more important in that situation. So you would choose the 10mm. And it doesn't have to be a truck. You could just think of something like, well, what if someone comes to the mall and starts shooting and they have cover and I have cover, like we both take cover behind two big garbage receptacles or something. Well, I want my round to penetrate that garbage receptacle and still do damage. The 9mm might not be able to do that. The 10mm would be much more likely to do that. So you might choose the 10mm in that case also. Let's say you are someone who's worried about active shooter situations where you might have to engage a bad guy from a little bit of a distance. You may not have time to get up to them, or you may not have time to actually wait until they're close to you to start fighting back, or else they'll harm other people. So in that case, you're going to worry more about accuracy. Well, that one's going to be a hard one because you're going to think about a couple of different things. The 10mm is going to be a little more accurate at distance. It's not going to have as much drop, but it's not going to be a big difference. So you might want to have more chances to hit the bad guy at distance, so you might want to have more rounds. It's really going to be which one you think is more important there, the slightly more accurate 10mm at distance, or more chances to actually hit the bad guy. So on that, you could go either way depending on your own personal thinking. Neither choice is right and neither choice is wrong. They're both your choice. Another situation where you might want to take the caliber versus the capacity into consideration is if an active shooter comes to where you work or just where you happen to be, and you have to fire on that active shooter and say he's prepared to take fire. So he's wearing light body armor. So a kill shot isn't something you're going to likely be able to get. You're just going to have to pump them full of holes in other places and hope they bleed out. Groin shots, inner thigh shots, whatever you can get on target. So you have to decide which is more important to you, the more powerful 10 millimeter or more rounds of 9 millimeter. And there can be arguments made for both. The deeper penetrating round with the more tissue damage might cause that guy to bleed out faster. But also, putting more holes in him might cause him to bleed out faster. 3 wounds from a 9mm might bleed out faster than 1 or 2 wounds from a 10mm. If you're only going to get one hit on him, of course the 10mm would probably have a more effective wound channel than the 9mm. But with the 9mm here, you've got more chances. So that's a decision you have to make. Which one of those things is more important to you? Once again, no right or wrong there. It depends on the circumstances, and it depends on what circumstances do you think it's most likely that you're going to face, and what option would you rather have. And then there's also things to consider, like what if you find yourself somewhere stranded with nothing but your EDC on you because of a natural disaster, etc. Do you want to have the 10 rounds of the 10mm, or would you rather have almost twice as many rounds of 9mm? In that situation, you might decide, I'd rather have the more rounds, it's going to last me longer and serve me better. And another factor you want to take into consideration for yourself is, which one of these guns can you handle? Can you shoot 10mm accurately? If you can't, it doesn't matter how much more powerful it is. If you can shoot 9mm accurately, but can't the 10mm, you should surely go with the 9mm. The small differences in performance aren't going to make up for the fact that you aren't hitting your target with the 10, but you can hit it with the 9. So in a case like that, definitely 9mm would be for you. Another lesser factor you could take into consideration is the cost of the ammo. If you're not going to practice with 10mm very much because it's expensive or hard to get, well, that's probably not a good thing. If you would practice a lot more with the 9mm to where you're more likely to actually hit your target in a bad situation, well, then maybe 9mm would be for you. Because you do need to practice with your gun. You do need to be able to use it effectively. And if you're not going to do that with the 10mm, that advantage of caliber, that small advantage, is meaningless. You would definitely want the 9mm so you can actually hit your target. And yes, I know some people are going to say, well, that's just a training issue. You need to learn to handle the 10mm. A lot of people aren't going to train that much. They're not going to train if the gun is hard for them to handle. They'll be discouraged. Not everyone's a professional. So things like that matter to some people, and that's something they have to take into consideration when choosing their everyday carry. So as you can see, there's lots of reasons why you would choose the higher capacity gun, and there's lots of reasons why you would choose the more powerful gun. And people are going to say, it's not really more powerful. It is more powerful, period. That's all there is to it. Whether it's more effective, that's a different question, but it is more powerful. So this is a very personal decision. You have to make this for yourself. No one else can make it for you. There is no right. There is no wrong. The very fact that you're carrying a gun is 99% of the job already done. You're already 99% of the way to being prepared. So choosing the caliber and the capacity, that's just a little bit more you have to do. And that is based on factors that are more important to you than maybe they are to someone else. Because part of carrying a gun isn't just being prepared, it's feeling prepared. It's like you are comfortable with what you chose, that it can deal with the situations that you are most concerned about facing. That's a big step towards being prepared and being able to deal with bad situations. That little extra confidence can make a difference. So like I said, no right, no wrong. The higher capacity could be right for you, but wrong for someone else. And the higher caliber could be right for someone else and wrong for you. It doesn't really come down to black and white. It is a gray area. It is something that is about perspective. It is a very subjective thing. There is no right. There is no wrong. And don't let anyone tell you there is. So having said that, which would you find more important? Would you rather carry something like the Beretta with, you know, 18, 19, 20 rounds that are well-performing rounds, but maybe not the most powerful rounds you can get? Or would you rather carry something like this Kimber here or something similar with 10 rounds of 10mm that are going to be more powerful, but you're going to give up that capacity? Now, when it comes to my decision, I don't really know. I got to admit, I go back and forth on this. I'll think of one thing that makes me think, well, the power is more important. And then I'll think of something else with, maybe capacity is more important. It really is something I go back and forth on. Luckily, I think both guns are going to handle most situations I ever come into. I'm never going to face a problem where that choice really makes a big difference. I'm pretty confident in that. But it is still something I think about when choosing my everyday carry. So like I said, you know what I think now, so let's hear what you think. What's more important, capacity or caliber?
Oops.
Is that correct?